it's JJ here from Forever Flying back with another video. In today's video, I'm going to be giving you guys 5 tips for your aerial front swing or your aerial semi. Here we go. Alright, so before we move on to the 5 tips, the prerequisites for an aerial semi or an aerial front swing are kind of butterfly kick, aerial, and skip hook kick. And as I said, this video is a 5 tips video, so it's not a full tutorial. However, there is a full detailed tutorial that I've released on Adrenaline Worldwide. I will leave the link to that video in the description, and I'll leave all my codes and stuff down below as well, so go check it out. All right, so starting with tip number one. Tip number one is about spotting. So it's gonna be spotting the floor, and that's for when you take off and also whilst you're doing the move. So when you go into it, generally I tend to start with like a double step, or occasionally I'll do it from hook kick or standing, whatever you prefer, it doesn't really matter. But when you get to just before the takeoff, for my takeoff, I tend to look not straight ahead, although I'm going this direction. I look slightly angled, so probably like 30 degrees out from my foot. So if I'm going this way, I'll be spotting about here. And that really helps for when you take off, bringing your chest up, because you're looking kind of here. And then as you take off, you're still looking for that spot. You come around to see it again. And then if you're gonna be doing something out of it, you'll probably change your focus to a bit more in front of you as you pull that leg through for your aerial front swing. So yeah, tip number one is about spotting the floor. And as you can see, my eyes are focused on the same point throughout the whole move, except for the spin step. Tip number two is about your chest whilst you're doing your aerial semi or your aerial front swing. As you know, for aerial front swing and aerial semi and stuff, the end position is kind of here with your chest up. So it's really important that when you take off, you're dropping your chest into your takeoff. So you come down to here, but you can't leave it there throughout the whole aerial front swing because you won't arrive in this position. So it's almost like you come down for your takeoff. As soon as that leg lifts up, you're spotting the floor, you take off, and you're instantly crunching to pull your chest up and get to that position. So tip two, chest goes down on takeoff, and you bring it up as fast as you can. You wanna be landing up, chest up, leg in front, to allow that back swing motion with your leg. And this part of the aerial front swing is kind of why I tell people to treat it more like a butterfly kick, because although the first leg to come off the floor does seem to come up, the way I'm thinking about it is more through my focus point, and I'm more pulling it around the side, which helps me to bring my chest up. Whereas if you go for it, and you go straight like a normal aerial, and you pull both feet over the top, you're gonna find it really hard to get to this position, and it's gonna look a lot different. And that leads on to step three, which is about the first leg that comes off of the ground. So as I just said about if you go for a normal aerial, your feet will both come straight up. Whereas for the aerial semi or the aerial front swing, you'll notice the first leg comes up, and because I've been doing it for a long time, it looks like I'm bringing it straight up, but I'm focusing more on coming around. For starting, I often tell people to do it like this. You do it like a vertical skip hook kick. So you go set and go, because it gets you used to pulling your leg more around the side as opposed to here, and pulling it around the side makes the second shape easy. So this is like shape one, this is shape two, which is the front swingy bit. So yeah, make sure that when you're starting off, you're not pulling your leg too high up, because you're gonna find the kind of front swing motion of the aerial semi or the aerial front swing a lot more difficult. Whereas if you pull it more around the side and treat it a bit more like a butterfly kick, it might not look exactly how you want it to begin with, but if you get comfortable with that, then you can really start to push your leg up higher and higher so it becomes more of an aerial. Tip number four is about keeping your chest in time with your leg. And this is so that you have the correct shape, but also it makes it easier to do front swing into something else like a raise or a touchdown raise or even wrap nine and stuff. How I do this, I grab my leg, But you often see people that don't grab their leg because it's not necessary. I just found it a lot easier to keep my leg in time with my chest if I held it for a bit. All that you need to do for this to keep your leg in time with your chest is make sure you keep your hips locked. If you like leave this leg ball loose, it's not going to be in time and you'll probably land with your chest up here and your leg's going to be there already and then your front swing's not going to be so good. But if you're landing here, you have a bit more time and you can also use that swing to your advantage into the next move. So you want to think about it like, you spot on the floor, you dip your chest, you kick your leg, you pop, you're pulling your chest up. You want to think about pulling your shin, or just your leg in general, up towards your chest to keep your hip flexed. If your hip isn't flexed, it's going to be like that. So you want your hip to be flexed. I'll show you guys me doing my aerial front swing with my leg grabs and without. So you can see it's, you can still do it without the grab, but the whole purpose is the same. It's like this, so that when you land, you can get that motion. So with the grab, and with that grab, I kind of grab kind of my calf muscle. It varies from like here to here. It's not really that important, and without the grab. But it's still the same shape. It's just not as comfortable for me. But you can see that even on the second one, I'm in this motion. I kick up, and then I'm like this crunched motion before my leg comes down. And the fifth and final tip for your aerial semi or aerial front swing is about the foot that lands first and the direction that it faces. When I started trying to do aerial front swings, this was a big problem for me. And when I fixed it, I found I was able to do a lot more out of it and a lot easier. So for the aerial front swings, you want to have your direction, whichever way the combo is going. If I'm coming towards you guys, I take off, I do all my shapes and stuff. I want my landing foot to be facing the direction that I'm going. So if I'm doing a front swing raise, even though normally when you raise, your foot's probably not gonna be straight in front, when you're doing it from an aerial front swing, it is. So you go here, boom, take off, land, foot facing the direction that you're going. It just makes it easier and it's also a little bit easier to block, okay? Because everything's in one line and it almost mimics a Webster takeoff. It's not quite a Webster takeoff, but it's similar. Depending on which way you do your Websters, maybe it will be like a Webster takeoff, but for me, I Webster off my other leg, which is a bit unfortunate because I'd probably be able to do a much better front swing raise if I Webster off my right leg, but I don't. Like I said, sometimes I used to do it like this, my foot will be here, or like even a bit more round if you're used to just doing normal aerial and you're trying to turn your hips and you leave your foot, and that's just going to put a lot of strain on your knee and you're not going to have the flow. You're probably going to end up landing and then having to pivot, which ruins the whole flow of the aerial front swing or aerial semi. So yeah, fifth and final tip, make sure that when you do it, you take off and when you're coming down to land, foot faces the direction you're going, and then you want to swing straight back with your leg and go into whatever's next. So those are my five tips for aerial front swings and aerial semis. I hope that you were all able to understand the tips I gave and that you guys will find them useful. As I said, if you didn't find that these tips were enough for you, there is a full detailed tutorial on aerial front swing where I talk about the tips that we spoke about today, but in a bit more detail on Adrenaline Worldwide. As I said, link is down below. I'll leave all my codes there and stuff. So yeah, if you want a little bit more detail about it, go check that out. Thank you all for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.